the world's changed in the last couple of weeks. What is this thing we're going through? What do we call it?
Well, we call it a pandemic.
Yeah.
You know, and everyone is, I think people are realizing that this is a significant change. And unfortunately, all of us, myself included, I think we don't change something to this magnitude. And whether it'll be a long-term change or a short-term change, I don't know. There are a lot of opportunities for long-term changes in the way we live, in the way we operate, in the way we do this, in the way we communicate. So that definitely is a positive thing from everything that's happening. Short term, you know, it's as a health issue, but it's quickly moving into an economic issue with so many people being unemployed. The good thing is we started from a strong economy, and it's the economy causing the downturn. It's really the health issues that are in the downturn. And I think if you get control eventually of these health issues, then you're going to see sort of a V-shaped recession or something where we'll go down there and we'll go very quickly. That's the way I'm trying to look at it right now. Unless the thing hangs on for months or a year, we're really going to situation.
I hope you're right. What do you hear from accounting firms right now? What are they going through, and what can you suggest to them?
Yeah, I think this thing couldn't have come at a worse time, especially in the middle of tax season and everything. So I think let's look at March. So you look at March and you look at the last 2 weeks, I think most accounting firms and most businesses were just trying to figure out, the larger they were, how to work remotely with their people, what technology to use, whether it's Zoom like you and I are using right now, or some of the other places, doing some training with their people on how to do this, working with their clients, trying to give some comfort to their clients as well as to their staff at the same time. I would say that for the last, say, 4 weeks or so, most firms have just been trying to survive. I don't know. And again, they're, you know, if you look at some of the big four firms, whether they had some sort of crisis contingency plan or not, you would hope so. But, you know, most businesses don't have something that hits hard and quick as we've been hit by this coronavirus.
What should accounting firms be doing first?
Well, I think the first thing, the most important thing, is making sure their people are safe and their people practice the proper medical procedures, hygiene procedures that we're being told, to wash your hands, to do, stay away from people. I think if you lose your people to a virus, or if you lose some key people in a firm, God forbid, I mean, that could have a tremendous effect on some firm. If you lose a managing partner who's really been driving the firm, or you lose several members of an executive committee, that can have an impact on the firm, because we know most firms don't have a large bench strength in order to replace somebody that quickly. I think they'll survive, but, you know, it's going to be tough. And maybe when it's over, will you see an increase in more mergers? I don't know.
When the dust settles, how will the accounting business look and operate differently?
And that's the great unknown. So two scenarios you could look at. One, it goes back to business as usual, which might not happen. But the second one is that it becomes much more, I don't know if decentralized is the right word, but it becomes much more remotely. There are more people working remotely than ever before, and people working with their clients a little bit differently than they have. So I think that could be one of the major changes. The other change that I think a lot of people are going to look at and say, all right, what I've been doing in my life, given the scare, is this really important now? You know, when you go through something like this and you sort of look, what on my tombstone? Well, he worked 10,000 hours a year. God bless him. But he had no life, he had no family, like friends, et cetera, like that. So I think you could see a lot of people revisiting what they thought was important to them. I mean, we've been able to live without going to the shows, without socializing, without going to bar, without doing all these things. And life goes on, and it's sort of nice.
Are all strategic initiatives shelved? Is there anything they can do for the long term? Are they all focused on the short term?
I think the firms are still looking at strategic issues. I don't think those are going to be called off. I think short term, you're probably not going to see any mergers or acquisitions for 5 or 6 months till this thing goes through. Nobody wants to be near anyone else. So that's going to pretty much stop it. And we are in the middle of tax season. So I think firms are trying to get by maybe to July 15th now with the extension for the tax filings and everything that firms have. So that's taken some of the pressure off. And if they're communicating with their clients, they can sort of get back to a normal life. They've got another 90 days to get everything with no penalties, you know. So after that, I think it's anybody's, maybe more smaller firms will think about having a little bit more security. But, you know, firms, my experience has been is that most firms have merged because of lack of financial wherewithal or lack of the next generation of leaders coming up. For those firms that are strong, they'll just continue the way they are. And the weaker firms may try and do something, but they've never been at an advantage anyways.
If past recessions are any guide, there are always winners and losers. There's consolidation, there's shakeout. Can you tell today which firms will be winners and which firms will be losers?
Just in general, I would say those firms that have created more of a culture around them and have values are going to be the winners. So if you look at the consulting firms, the Accentures of the world, the McKinseys of the world that have strong culture, they're invest in their people. And those firms that have done a lot of mergers just for the sake of doing mergers might be more at risk. Yeah. So.
Thank you, August.
Okay.
Be safe.
Bye-bye.